close your eyes and take 3 deep breaths. When you open your eyes, you'll most likely be drawn to one of the 3 piles. And that is the pile that has the messages that you are meant to hear. If you are drawn to more than one pile, there are likely messages in both or all piles that you are drawn to. Enjoy.
You chose pile 1, this is your reading. We have past life, present power. As the soul grows in service to the great feminine and her intention that all beings be healed and free, it gathers internal resources to assist on the path. These resources include powers and gifts from other lifetimes. You are currently integrating past life abilities. Be open to what is taking place at your soul. As your soul awakens ancient power and abilities within you. Beautiful. So if you feel called to try something that you haven't done in a long time, or just like, you know, you hear about it and it really intrigues you, go after those things, because those are like little breadcrumbs that are leading you down a higher path. And some of these things you might have mastered in a past life, and so you're getting the chance to really hone in on these talents and abilities and bring it back into your life this time around. So just pay attention to, you know, opportunities that arise and notice what brings you passion, what brings you joy, and go after more of that to really bring the fuel to your fire and begin to really enjoy life and what feels natural for you. So that's a wonderful card. We have honor and trust your feelings. Thank you, Archangel Michael, for supporting, guiding, and protecting me as I listen to and act upon my feelings. Help me understand and express my emotions with love. Beautiful. So honoring anything that's coming up for you, especially around this time. You know, eclipses tend to bring out a lot of things that have been hidden, or it brings out sometimes a lot of more challenges or things that may cause triggers. So as anything comes up for you, just make sure you take the time to sit with those feelings that arise. Remember, emotions are energy in motion, so you have to allow them to pass through, and really so you can acknowledge and accept and heal as the emotions are coming and as you fully feel what's arising for you, so you're not suppressing or repressing anything down into your body. And this is going to allow you to feel more open and more relaxed and at peace as you dive more into those layers within you. And remember that Archangel Michael is here supporting you, guiding you, and protecting you as you listen to and act upon your feelings. And this will help express what's on your mind and what's in your heart with compassion, with love, not only to yourself, but to the others in your life. And so that you can, you can dive deeper into that, understand yourself better, and so that the world can understand you better as well and where you're coming from. Gorgeous. So we have, so you're going to be taking some action, and this is going to open up communication, whether it's, you know, with the universe, whether it's someone important that's coming into your life, that will give you an opportunity, but you are about to take inspired action, and communication is in the works, and it's going to feel like a very fresh new opportunity that you can take hold of. So make sure that you say yes after, of course, feeling into your intuition, making sure that it's for you. And then going after it if you feel that it is in alignment with you and that it sparks joy and sparks something within you that makes you want to go get it. And we have, the moon. Things that previously have been hidden are coming to light. And this is also like the shadow aspects of you. Things that, parts of you that maybe you haven't fully looked at or you've kind of hidden away. You're now like, your eyes are open to that. You are ready to see beyond the veil. You are ready to see what's really going on behind the surface and not just take things at face value anymore. You are reading into the energy, feeling into the energy, and you aren't willing or letting anybody pull a fast one on you because you are going to be more in tune with the underlying energy so that you know with discernment what is for you and what is not, who is for you and who is not, and that kind of thing. So you're also going to be heading into this direction with this new opportunity that's going to come in, that's going to give you so much contentment and it's going to make you feel so good. It's like you're nearing a completion of a cycle and things are getting easier and you're just like, you know, full belly, full heart. You're just content with life and where it's going and the opportunities that you're able to take hold of, and that's really beautiful. And now we have the world. So the world is your oyster. You know, you're gaining so much more perspective and awareness about your path and like why certain things have happened the way that they have. And now you are gaining new experiences and you're gaining some opportunities that are going to be available to you. And this is going to help you see the world. It's going to help you have new eyes and see through new eyes and begin to grow just so much more than you ever thought possible. And this is going to allow you to just feel so much more whole and so much more at peace within yourself. So that is beautiful. At times, you know, your emotions might get the best of you, but just remember to take a deep breath and remember to observe your feelings as they arise. Can you detach yourself and see things from a little bit of a third party perspective so that you're not as emotionally involved with the situation? Because sometimes when we're too close to it, you know, our emotions cloud our judgment. So if you just detach a little bit and try to get an outside perspective and see things from different points of view, this will help you calm your emotions and think clearly so that you can make the best possible choice and best possible action for your highest and greatest good with those balanced emotions. So just remember to take those deep breaths when you feel triggered or when emotions arise within you. Take those breaths from your belly. You can do the four, inhale, pause for four, exhale for four, as many times as you feel the need to. And this is going to help reduce the stress in your body, and it's going to help calm your mind, calm your body, so that you can like tune into yourself, that inner sentience within you that's going to allow anything that's turbulent to settle, so you can feel like you're in calmer waters and then make a decision based on that like more calm energy rather than, you know, making decisions when you're like in the midst of like, you know, crashing waves of emotions. Okay. And so these emotions that sometimes are unbalanced might have had to do with your heart that was broken at one point, but you are doing massive healing and you are actually recovering from this heartbreak, and this is allowing you to find more value in your experiences because you are aware that things have happened the way that they were meant to in order for you to learn lessons. And so this has allowed you to gain more perspective about those situations so you can heal your heart. And this is helping you to move towards calmer waters, and it's helping you gain perspective, gain more awareness of what you've gone through and like where the universe is guiding you. And now through that newfound perspective, you're able to take action steps and take opportunities that feel really good to your soul and just feel so much contentment from within. So this is coming from this contentment is a big switch for you, because it wasn't too long ago when you were just like looking at your life, looking at what you had created so far and being like, could be better, don't love it, you know, like just not like really into it. But this also could have been like during your healing of your heart, because when your heart gets broken, it's very common to just numb yourself out. And because, you know, those feelings are so strong that you're like, nope, not going to feel anymore. I'm going to take a break from feeling, and I'm actually going to go a little bit numb. And so when that happens, it can bring some like dullness into other aspects of your life. And I see that you have overcome this, and you are now taking charge and taking steps through this newfound clarity, this newfound awareness, that's allowing you to take new opportunities that feel good for you, that make you feel whole, that bring more passion and fire from within you. And this is what's leading to your contentment, finding that fire, that joy in your daily life. And so you are still needing to work on boundaries, setting boundaries to make sure that you are in a space where you're not selling yourself short, where people aren't walking all over you, where you're not being a people pleaser. So set those healthy boundaries and really tune into what you need to be doing at whatever, like whatever's going on. You know, if you're invited to go somewhere, or, you know, for example, tune into yourself to see if that's a good choice for you or not. And with through this discernment and through this boundary setting, boundaries like in regards to like relationships or your work-life balance or creating time for yourself, these boundaries are going to give you like these parameters that are going to ensure that you have that balance between, you know, rest and inspired action. You know, the masculine taking leaps of forward movement, and that feminine energy drawing back, reflecting, coming into yourself. So making sure that you follow your intuition and set those boundaries where they're needed so that you can keep this balanced energy moving forward, so that you can continue to take action when you're required to, and so that you can continue to take these opportunities when they arise, because you balance your energy and you've taken that time to rest. You've taken that time for yourself when somebody wanted you to do something, and in another time you would have been like, you know what, not feeling it, but I'm really going to do it because I know you need me there. But if it's not for your highest good and it's not serving you and it's actually depleting you, these are the things that your spirit guides are asking you to take a step back from. Set those healthy boundaries. You know, if you need to reschedule, just tune into yourself and see what will serve you best. And when you serve yourself first, it will best serve everybody else as well. So keep that in mind. So there's a nearing of a cycle here as you gather the Ten of Wands. Now there might be an obstacle or distraction that's preventing you from fully completing what it is that you're set out to do, but know that this is just a temporary hiccup. And once that's resolved, once you pick that last puzzle piece or set that final healthy boundary, you're going to catapult yourself forward into this action phase where, you know, things are just aligning and you're going at it full force, ready to take on what it is that you deserve and ready to accomplish those goals and live in that dream life. And so as you move forward bravely and boldly, you have to trust the process, because even though you're taking action and you're trying to like make these major leaps and bounds forward, just remember that it might not reflect that fast forward movement in your reality right away. You might be taking all this action step and being like, okay, well, why do I feel like I'm in the same spot? Like, why does it feel like I'm not going anywhere? Well, have you ever seen a cat run so fast that at first it's not moving? Well, that's what I'm picking up on from you. So it's like you are just like hitting the ground running and you're not seeing any progress right away because you're running so fast that you're actually like gaining traction and you're not really moving yet. And then as soon as you get that traction, boom, you are just like, you're just gone and you're taken up and like launching out into, you know, whatever it is that you are going for. So don't be worried when it feels like you're not, you know, really seeing right away the reflection of all this action that you're taking. Like, remember, everything is as is for a reason, and you are just like hitting the ground running and you're going to take off. So please do not worry. You are in beautiful energy that's allowing you to smell the roses, hear the sounds of the birds, feel the wind blowing, like feel the sunshine on your face, just like being in this present moment that makes you feel so good, that makes you feel gratitude for all that you have in your life. And just knowing that everything is working out for you and everything has happened for a reason. And now you are just taking all of the important steps you need to take in order to align yourself with your goals, your dreams, and your desires. This was a beautiful reading and I am so happy for you. And I'm wishing you the most beautiful year because it's a new astrological year in Aries, or starting with Aries. And I'm wishing you all of the best. I know that this is going to be a beautiful season in your life. So take good care and I'll see you in the next reading. If you chose group two, this is your reading. So we have Queen of Pentacles. So you are creating such abundance in your life. You are sitting in your power and you know that you are the creator of your reality. And whatever it is that you want to make happen, you can make it happen. And you believe in yourself and you have strong intuition and you have strong personal power. You know who you are. You're authentic. You're full of integrity. You're genuine. And this is allowing you to really blossom and bloom into this beautiful, you know, goddess or god that you are. Like, you are grounded in who you are. And because you follow your guidance system and your intuition, it always leads you in the right direction. It always leads you to new opportunities. It always leads you to the path of prosperity because you're fueling into yourself. And as you fuel into yourself, you provide that energy and self-love, and that pours into everybody and everything else in your life. And the universe provides for you in this way because you are so, like, you are so in your power and so ready to help anyone that needs it, as long as, you know, it's in alignment with you and your goals, your morals, your values. As you help yourself, you help others, and as you help others, the universe rewards you for that, and it is giving you so many blessings, so much abundance, not only abundance of like prosperity, but health and happiness and joy. So that is absolutely beautiful. You are gaining so much like wisdom and growth and like new awareness from being this version of you. That's just so tapped into who it is that you are. And sometimes it feels like there is just so many options out there, like you don't know which path to take, but know that your guidance system is always leading you down the path that's meant for you. And when you feel unsure about something, just like take three deep belly breaths and just follow that gut instinct. Follow your joys. Follow those feelings that arise that make you feel good. And when something feels unsettled within you, know that that's not the right path for you. You are beginning to feel more grounded in who you are. And this is like a huge step up because in the past, I don't think that you really felt solid in who you were. And you were trying to kind of fit yourself in a box and trying to be what other people wanted you to be. And lately, you've been stepping into your power. You've been honoring your heart and, you know, the essence of who you are at a soul level, and you are grounding this self-love into your life, and you are being rewarded for this. You have so much more calmness and so much more acceptance in who you are, and this is going to ripple out into all aspects of your life. It's been a kind of like a juggling act to get to this point, but know that as you really, really listen to your guidance and your intuition, you gain so much more clarity and so much more like assurance. You just know what's for you and what's not. And this is what's going, this discernment, this is what's going to bring you the balance that you so need. And sometimes it feels like you're just blindfolded, your hands are behind your back, you feel like stuck, like there's nothing that you can do to get yourself out of the situation. But know that that is just coming from a part of you that is trying to protect yourself. It's trying to prevent you from doing something outside of your comfort zone because it wants to keep you safe. And as you take off the blinders and you free your own hands and realize that you have so much potential and that you are so like wonderful just as you are, that there's so many opportunities for you, that you are going to free yourself. And it's this mindset shift that's going to free you and that's going to allow you to be grounded in that self-acceptance, that self-love, and bring in all the abundance that is meant for you through staying true to yourself, through honoring yourself, through following your guidance and your intuition, and knowing that anything that feels like restrictive or makes you feel like you're being blinded from the truth, make sure that you stray away from those people, that those situations, because that is not the path for you. You can see through beyond the veil, and you have so much more awareness than you think sometimes. And when you tap in to your intuition and the feelings within you, you will begin to really see the facade that people are trying to be viewed as, or you're going to be able to clearly see the restrictions and restrictions and the parameters that people are using to try to control you, when in reality you are a sovereign being of light, and in reality you are the creator of your world, of your life. So you can take off these blinders, you can undo your hands, you can free yourself from all of these constraints, and you can bring yourself back to yourself, honoring your intuition, honoring your heart, honoring that integrity that you have within you to be the version of yourself that you are proud of. You know, where you are honoring your spirit, you are honoring your soul, you are honoring your heart. And as you do that, you will absolutely break free from any constraints that anyone is trying to constrain you with. So we also have the Queen of Wands. So again, you are trusting your intuition. You are creating a life that is full of prosperity and abundance and happiness and joy from you following your intuition. So the key for you is trusting yourself, trusting your guidance, trusting your heart, trusting your spirit, okay? And knowing that when you follow your intuition, you're being led to your highest timeline, free from constraints, free from anything that's weighing you down or holding you back. And as you trust yourself and you follow your inspirations, you follow your joys, your passions, what makes your heart full, what lights your soul up, you find balance again. You find clarity. You free yourself from this unknowing of what to do, and you realize that it's up to you. That you are, if that, you can realize that the person that's holding you back from following your dreams is that version of you that's still trying to keep you safe. And as you say, no, I'm going to trust my heart, trust my spirit, trust my intuition, and follow what feels good and true for me, following my integrity, you are being freed. You're freeing yourself. And you are up-leveling into this level of mastery where you are the queen of... You are the queen of pentacles and the wands. You are the queen of your creative spark and of abundance. The universe is providing for you in all ways that you need and is rewarding you because you are following your intuition and you are honoring yourself and you are freeing yourself from anything that's weighing you down and holding you back. You're finding balance and clarity by trusting your intuition. And the Sun card is coming up in reverse here. The Hermit is coming in too. So your happiness right now is wanting to come in, but there's a period of reflection that you need to be going through first. I believe that you are going to have this happiness, but it's not going to come right away. It's a little bit of an obstacle that's in the way of you finding this pure bliss and happiness, this rejoice, and before you fully step into that happy, prosperous, joyous time period, you're going to have to go in reflection mode. Really see what has been holding you back and what has been making you feel unsettled or unclear. What are the constraints that have been put on you? What are the ties that are like literally holding you down? And through this reflection, you're going to gain more clarity and you're going to be able to free yourself. So know that the Sun is here for you. The Sun is the best card in the deck. There are so much joyous and happy times ahead, but this reflection time is so necessary in order to take the step into that beautiful time, that happy, prosperous, wonderful time. You need this reflection. And you can see he's like holding his lantern in the Hermit card here, tuning into himself, you know, holding on to his staff, connecting to spirit while grounding his energy. And, you know, this lantern, this light from within, is going to turn into the Sun, into this radiant, vibrant, vivacious energy. And first, it's just going to need you to take the time to tune in and to see what it is that you need and to give yourself that love and anything that you require in order for you to heal and to give yourself that love that you deserve. You know, there might have been some deceptive energies around you, but just know that that's all being sorted out and that it's not something you need to be worrying about. There's a new beginning that's here for you. But first, you need to take that time to reflect before heading into these new beginnings that bring so much success and so much joy. There are new opportunities that are available for you, and this is coming in quick, and it's going to be like as soon as you take that time to reflect and heal from any energies that you've suppressed, you are going to be rewarded with an opportunity that is leading you down a new path. And it's going to feel like it comes out of the blue, and it's going to feel like so good, and you're just going to know that this is meant for you. You are able to hold on to your passions, your joys, your inspirations, what motivates you, what makes you feel courageous, what makes you feel bold. And through you tuning into all of the things that light you up, you are aligning yourself to this happy time period in your life. Because through this reflection, you are gaining insight into what it is that makes you feel so good and what makes you feel so whole. And this opportunity is related to the sense of wholeness that you get clarity on. And this, your spirit guides want you to remember that when there's a loss, it can be easy to focus on the loss, but you have to just like feel those feelings and let it go, and then recalibrate and focus on what is there for you. In this card, he's focusing on the three spilled cups while there's two cups still standing here. And quality over quantity. Like, as soon as you begin to, you know, tune in and feel gratitude for what you do have and feel grateful for all the things in your life that already bring you joy and already fill your cup up and fuel your fire, you are going to find it easier to focus on the good in your life. And it's fully okay to feel sad about letting something go or a loss of something, but it's just important that you don't stay in that energy too long, because it will prevent your other blessings from coming in, which is not something that we want. We want you to fully feel those feelings of loss and upset and sadness if you need to, so that you can heal those energies, allow them to pass through you, and so that you can reach for the for that better feeling, for, you know, the things in your life that are going to add so much more to your life. Not take away, but like add extra energy to you, add extra love, add extra joy. And whatever it is that you can focus on what is there for you, what is going right, that will allow you to attract in more of those things. And so it's, and just as if you're focusing too much on the loss, then you're going to attract more loss and more sadness. And that's not what we want. We want you to sort through those feelings, heal them, feel them, and then move on to the better feeling, to what you are grateful for what is going right for you. And knowing that as you focus on what's going right, more of that will come in. And we have Make a Commitment. Archangel Michael, as the angel of courage and confidence, I call upon you to lend me your strength. Allow me to commit to myself, my life, and my divine purpose. Please clearly guide me so that I can fully open my heart to every experience. Beautiful. So call Archangel Michael in for that boost of courage and confidence and strength so that you can commit to yourself, your life, and your divine purpose. Allowing him to guide you so that you can fully open your heart to every experience, good and bad, knowing that the bad gives you perspective and gives you every experience is so necessary in your process of evolution. And when you open your heart to seeing that, you don't have to repeat lessons that you've had in your life, because you've learned the lesson and you've gained perspective on it, you've experienced it, you've healed, and then you can let it pass and like extract that wisdom and help it serve you in other areas of your life and help serve other people as well. So that is beautiful. And then we have Key of Life. The ankh portends new life being born through you now. This new life being born in whatever form will enrich your life, bringing you more into wholeness and fulfillment. Do not give up on your creative destiny. Stay with it. You are flowing in the right direction, and you have spiritual support from the unseen worlds. Let it happen. Your beautiful time period is nearly here. It is here, you know. You just need this time of reflection to, you know, you just need this time of reflection for your healing, and then you can begin to step into this journey with this new opportunity that's going to bring you so much love, so much joy, where you're following your intuition, following your heart, staying true to yourself, staying in your integrity, feeling grounded in your love, finding that balance in your life, finding clarity, releasing the chains, releasing any restrictions and constraints, knowing that as you reflect on your life, you free yourself from limitations. You can step into this new journey that you're on and release anybody from the past that has been deceptive, knowing that as you focus your attention onto what is going good for you, what is good and true for you, you will continue to attract that in your life. Hold on to your inspirations and what brings you joy, because that is the fuel to your fire. Make a commitment to yourself through courage, through boldness, through strength, to follow your purpose, and know that you are divinely being led there. You have this key of life within you that is leading you towards your creative destiny, which is going to bring you so much joy, so much happiness, so much abundance. And you have that spiritual support from the unseen worlds that are helping you anchor this into your life. So that is absolutely beautiful. I know this is going to be such an amazing year for you, and I'm wishing you all of the best. You can make amazing things happen in your life, and you have the power to do so. I love you. Take good care. If you chose group three, this is your reading. Let's see. The person you're asking about is trustworthy. Thank you for helping me have faith so I can open my heart wider in my relationships. I am grateful for your protection, ensuring that only trustworthy people are in my life. Beautiful. So you can rest assured knowing that you are attracting only trustworthy people, and anyone that is not trustworthy is not in your life right now. So trust that, and know that if relationships have fallen away, it's for a good purpose. And if you feel like you've been left out in the cold, trust me, the cold is a better place to be than with people that are untrustworthy and deceptive. So you are in the right place, and so trust that. Okay? There has been some chaotic energy around you. Maybe people have been fighting, maybe different energies that are like pulling you in all sorts of different directions. And just know that you can find calmness within the eye of the storm. So as there's chaos around you, tune within, connect to your breath, and find that calmness within yourself that will help you make a clear choice, make you find the answer that you're looking for, help you be guided down the path that is meant for you, to find the solution that is best for you and that's best for everybody. So always tune within whenever you feel triggered or whenever things arise. And trust me, I know that it is so hard sometimes to just like pull yourself out of negative energy. And if you can just kind of force yourself in that moment to just close your eyes, separate yourself, you need to take those three long deep breaths from your belly. If you can just tune into your body and just breathe through it and say like something positive to yourself, you can move more easily through that situation, through that energetic switch in you. And I know it's hard at the moment, but the more you practice, the easier it will get. There's justice being served from this chaotic energy, and it is happening for a reason, and it's allowing people's true colors to shine. So pay attention to when that chaotic energy comes forward to see what it reveals and what you gain insight on. There is a melding and blending and balancing of different elements that is going to help you find that balance between your personal life, your social life, your family life, your career. So this beautiful blending and melding of energies is going to make you feel really balanced and whole and at peace within yourself and in your daily life. You are like being guided to like be in the spotlight and to show yourself, show your truth, show yourself in your beauty and your authenticity, but there's something that's preventing you from fully shining in all of who you are. And this might come from like a period because you haven't fully taken the time that you need to sort out emotions or sort out situations that have happened, and this is kind of blocking you from fully like expressing yourself in your truth, in your wholeness. And once you begin to go into reflection mode and kind of turn on the light of your awareness as to what's going on for you, you will gain insight, and that will help you find this more of this balanced energy and to release things of the past so you can feel comfortable expressing you and all of who you are and expressing what's on your heart within your mind and allowing you to fully embrace your true self, your essence. There has been tough situations in your life, but every time situations arise that have a feeling of darkness around it, you have the power, you have the strength, you have the knowing to go within yourself. You are the eye of the storm, okay? You find the light in the darkness. You go within and you begin to see why things are happening the way that you are. You extract the knowledge as it's happening from this going in within yourself, and this is allowing you to find peace in the chaos, find peace in the darkness, find light in the darkness. And this is so healing for you. This is helping you set a new foundation for your life of balance, of wholeness, of peace. And this is every time you're able to just tune into yourself when there's this feeling of darkness around you, it allows you the light to flow in you more easily and allow you to even see more. Where things have been dark, now you can see more. You can peer behind the veil. You see energy for what it is. You see light for what it is, and then you see the darkness for what it is. And you know that there needs to be both, because you can't see the light if there's no darkness. And when there's this feeling of chaos or of darkness, when you know that you can just go within yourself and open up communication within yourself to see how you're feeling, to see what's going on within you, you can really heal so deeply. And you are eliminating the need for you to go through these kind of triggering experiences again, because you're healing it in the moment, which is so powerful. So sometimes you might kind of trudge those feelings underwater, like suppress them so that you can carry on with life. But know that whenever it is that these feelings arise within you, it's important that you take that time to fully reflect in order for you to gain that wisdom quicker, so you don't have to repeat those experiences, and so that you can just tap into that balanced energy that much more, that allows you to shine your true colors, just knowing that everything is happening as it's meant to, and justice will always be served, so you don't have to worry. You're releasing the chains that have been holding you back and weighing you down, and this is allowing you to free yourself from the past and situations that haven't had your best interest at heart. There's a creative project that you want to begin with, but you haven't had that full creative spark to fully get that going. But just remember that as you take that time to reflect on your life and gain that clarity as to what steps you need to take next, as soon as you turn that light of awareness on, as to shining in your truth, following your true essence, allowing yourself to be seen, you will begin to gain this clarity as to what creative project you are being guided to embark on or create. So this is something that's going to bring you so much happiness, and it's going to bring you so much strength. It's going to help you tame these inner beasts that have been within you, tame this chaos that's been in your energy field. And when you tap into yourself, find that awareness of what needs to be seen, heard, felt, acknowledged, you gain so much more strength within you, and you have the power and that motivation and inspiration to create what it is that you are meant to create. And whenever these energies come up that make you feel heavy, that weigh you down, that hold you back, remember that that is not the truth. That is not what your higher self has in store for you. So remember that that is only an illusion. Remember your courage, remember your strength, remember what lights your soul on fire, what brings you joy, what brings you inspiration. Remember who you are, what energy it is that makes you feel full of integrity and allows you to be fully genuine in who you are. And that is what's setting the foundation for yourself. And remember that strength comes from within. And as you tune into that strength, you allow yourself to be in an energy that you, where you are the leader of your life and you can make things happen. And anything that's trying to slow you down or weigh you down or make you feel less than is not the truth and is just trying to blindfold you from that power that you have, because they don't want you to succeed. Not everybody wants you to succeed, but you are being led down a path that is for your highest good, and you are in a season of your life where you are eliminating people that are weighing you down, that are holding you back. You are ridding them from your life, and because they're not serving you any longer. So you are preparing yourself to release these situations, release these people, release this chaos, release anything that is not of your highest good, so you can set a strong foundation of your life based on this strength, based on this courage, based on this creative project, based on being true to you, shining bright, allowing people to see you for who you are, trusting that everything is as it's meant to be, and justice will absolutely be served. Queen of Heaven. Oh! The Queen of Heaven, the divine empress of the skies, acknowledges your feminine authority now. As a man or a woman, you have a life path of spiritual leadership to bring qualities of mercy, compassion, and wisdom to the world. It first starts with you. You are anchoring all of these qualities within yourself in this moment. Mercy, compassion, and wisdom. And as you heal yourself, you also heal the world. You pave the path and you make way for others to follow you. Follow your path, follow your light. And this is creating such heaven. So that is so beautiful. So remember that the person you're asking about is trustworthy, and there's only trustworthy people in your life from here on out. And ask Archangel Michael to come in and help anchor that in for you, protect your energy, ensure that only trustworthy people are surrounding you and that are in your life and that are able to be in contact with you. And just know that things are working out for your highest and greatest good, and all you need to do is hone into that inner strength within you and know that you are going to be the one that's going to light your soul on fire and bring so much peace, tranquility, love into your life. So have a beautiful moon in Aries. This is going to be a beautiful year for you. Take good care. See you in the next reading. Hello. So we're going to be doing some intention magic for the new moon in Aries. And this is a big one because it's the start of the astrological year. So we want to set our intentions like we would the start of the traditional new year. So what are the things that you want to accomplish? What are the habits that you want to pick up? What are the situations you want to find yourself in? Who are the people that you want to surround yourself with? These are all the kinds of questions that you should ask yourself for what you want to bring in for yourself for this new year. So what you're going to do first is you're going to have a piece of paper, and first we're going to set our paper so that we are already welcoming in the energy that we put into it by the time we get there. So first, take your paper and have it straight up, and then tear it from the left to the right. And then you're gonna place that paper aside, turn it towards the right, and then pull from left to right, tearing that paper once again, turn the paper to the right, tear from left to right. Okay, turn to the right, and then we're gonna do this two times all the way around. So by the end, you should have 8 strips of paper, tearing from left to right each time. And there we go. So you can go ahead and count those if you like. So now you have your little magical piece of paper. You're going to write your name on it 3 times. Your name 3 times, your address 3 times, and the date 3 times. I'm using a yellow pen. because this is the color of the solar plexus. So we are getting a solar plexus activation with this Aries new moon. And on the other side, you're going to take that paper and then you are going to write at the top, I am attracting. And at the bottom, write, I have now attracted these blessings into my life, and then sign your name. Beautiful. So you can choose as many things as you wish. I'm going to pick three, but you can choose as little or as many as you wish. Turn that piece of paper on the side, on towards the right side, and then you're going to write those things three times once again, and you're going to be writing over top of what you've already written. So it'll get a little bit muddled, but don't worry, this is where the magic happens. And there we have it. So there is your beautiful piece of magical paper. And then on the other side where you have all your name written, you're gonna draw a perpendicular line or lines. And then you're going to pick a word. And then you're going to write it at the top of your paper. And you're gonna cancel out all the vowels. And you're gonna cancel out all the double letters. Then you're going to abstractly write those letters down on your perpendicular lines. So you, for example, part of an L could go here, part of an L could go here. So just abstractly breaking up that letter over those perpendicular lines. And then you're gonna box that in. So you're going to start at the left to the right, the top right to the bottom right to bottom left, and bottom left to top left. There we go. So all that magic is then contained there. If you wish, you can signature your name at the bottom. Beautiful. And there we have it. There is our intention magic. And then what we're going to do is you're going to take the top of the piece of paper and you're going to fold it down. You're going to turn it to the right, fold it down, turn it to the right, fold it down, and you're going to go around and around, folding each edge until you cannot fold that piece of paper anymore. Always folding towards you, because this is what we're attracting. If we were releasing something, we would be moving from right to left, but we're going left to right the whole time. And there we go. So now what you're going to do is you're going to take this piece of paper outside and you're going to light it on fire. And as you're lighting it on fire, you're going to sprinkle some cinnamon. And as the cinnamon catches the flames, it's going to add speed. So you're attracting this in with speed so that you can experience what it is that you want to experience that much sooner, that much more, like, it's going to be that much more accessible for you and bring you so much extra joy and oomph to your life. So I hope that you enjoy this intention magic. Have fun with it. Add your own pizzazz. Do whatever you feel called to do. And remember that you are the leader of your life and you can make happen whatever you want to make happen this lifetime. So take good care. Happy solar eclipse, new moon in Aries, and I'll see you again in the next video. Take care. I love you.